What'd you study?
Economics. I studied economics.
What I found to be one of the truest things is the people who are most successful in data science, data strategy, data governance, and really bringing business value do not typically have a computer science degree. Hi, my name is Christian Screen. I am a data strategy, machine learning, and analytics expert. I've been in the data strategy, machine learning, artificial intelligence space for 2 decades. I'm also founder of datalakehouse.io, which is a data orchestration and artificial intelligence platform that helps companies make sense of their data by filtering out the noise and providing insights in real time. Today, we're going to be looking at the movie Moneyball and determining how real it is.
Guys, you're just talking. Talking la 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 like this is business as usual. It's not.
We're trying to solve a problem here, Billy.
Not like this. You're not. You're not even looking at the problem.
Well, we're very aware of the problem. I mean...
Okay, good. What's the problem?
In any organization, when you're trying to solve a data problem, whether you have a data strategy or not, but you're just trying to make sense of what you're doing, what you have, you're trying to, you know, increase sales, you're trying to do something around data, you know, typical problems in any organization, every company is going to slightly vary. But this is so spot on. Once you finally get the one person who understands a true problem and can explain it very clearly to the rest of the team, it doesn't mean they're going to understand it, but it means that you've got the one person who's got the vision, and that's what it takes. This one, I have to give it a 10 out of 10.
47 doubles third place.
The problem we're trying to solve is that there are rich teams and there are poor teams. Then there's 50 feet of crap, and then there's us.
So using this equation on the upper left right here, I'm projecting that we need to win at least 99 games in order to make it to the postseason. We need to score at least 814 runs in order to win those games and allow no more than 645 runs.
The best people that can run a data strategy team or data team in general are the people who can go to the whiteboard, they can explain in any level, high, low, or medium level, what is going on, how this thing is going to work, what the algorithm is going to do, and they can speak to it from a value proposition perspective as well. What he's done here is by creating this whiteboard space, he already has algorithms and calculations and KPIs that are well defined, and he's explaining it to his boss in this case so that he can get validation for what he's put together. Now, he already knows this is going to work. He's bringing the vision to the vision, but he's doing it in such a way that it's hard to dispute the work that he's done that's going to allow things to move forward.
What's this?
This is the code that I've written for our year-to-year projections. This is building in all the intelligence that we have to project players.
Okay.
It's about getting things down to one number. Using stats the way we read them, we'll find value in players that nobody else can see.
This piece is just fun to look at, right? We're taking a look at some code. It's running pretty fast, I'm not sure what it actually is, but when you look at what's happening, you've got some spreadsheet concepts there. You know, spreadsheets still rule the world. They're all over the place. We need data entry. Any way we can get data in and then move it around and then transform it and wrangle it, that's what we want to do. We just need the orchestration tools to be able to take it from point A and put it into point B. But what they're not showing here is how the sausage is made, and that's okay. They're not showing who put the data into these spreadsheets. And we're not watching a set of coding activities take place either, and that's fine. But this is really what happens. Somebody has to write the code. Somebody has to do the data entry. We kind of see that it's done, and so we obviously presume it happened behind the scenes as part of the process, and that's accurate. So given this whole frame of the movie, a 10 out of 10, it's what I would do. And it's what some of the best data implementers and data strategists do.
They call it Moneyball.
Moneyball.
Yes, and it was a nice theory, and now it's just not working out.
Billy Beane has built this team on the ideas of a guy named Bill James.
Right.
Who wrote an interesting book on baseball statistics. The problem is that Bill James never played, never managed. He was, in fact, a security guard at a pork and beans company.
You see this as a decimation of the whole organization?
I think that he bought a ticket on the Titanic.
Oh, boy.
He's tried to come up with a new approach. My hat's off to him. It won't work.
What's really interesting is they're talking about how Bill James really didn't play baseball, this type of thing. And it's really interesting, though, but I think after seeing this movie, I've worked in at least a dozen and a half projects for Fortune 500 companies that have actually had a data strategy or data analytics machine learning projects codenamed Moneyball. So you have kind of this extrapolation of this idea that you can find these hidden gems within your own organization's data, whether that be, you know, sales teams, business development, supply chain, manufacturing, bill of materials. So all these types of things people have taken and ingested the concept into the organization. And some of them are really benefiting from this idea. And again, as we talked about at the beginning, you had that one person who had the vision. They were able to extrapolate that this Moneyball concept could work for their organization. And now, in turn, they've brought that in-house, codenamed the project Moneyball, and they're seeing some interesting gains, some very positive ones that I've been a part of and I've seen. So as far as, you know, taking this idea and moving forward with it, with the scene here, I'm going to have to give it a 10 out of 10.
Is losing fun?
No.
What are you having fun for?
So I like this scene. What are you having fun for? Is losing fun? I like this scene. And the way I like to think about this, and I see it quite often in really information technology in general, is that oftentimes when you have a full technical team, they don't really understand the business. It's hard to get them to get skin in the game of the business, whether you have a team that's in-house, you've got some offshore team or something like that. And so, you know, their paychecks aren't dependent on the success of the project a lot of times, right? So the incentive to make the project overly successful for them is kind of low versus the business or the stakeholders where it's very high. And I've seen this be problematic at some organizations, but you know, from a positive spin perspective, there are ways that you can incentivize your teams to bring out the absolute most intense way of applying and developing and integrating, you know, a data strategy or a data implementation project in the organization.
That's what losing sounds like.
Remind everybody that oftentimes there's consequences, and sometimes technology just seems like one of those really soft rubber stamp type of concepts. When it goes well, everybody's super happy that it went well. But when it goes poorly, sometimes it gets swept under the rug, and you know, typically the person that gets blamed is the department that's sponsoring the initiative. Whereas sometimes I think some of that blame needs to be shared, and some of the people, particularly in IT, need to be made aware that the success is also part of their initiative as well. You know, they need to have skin in the game. So I found this one interesting. I give this one a 10 out of 10 for sure.
Something strange is now happening at Oakland. You cannot argue the point
straight,
right now.
We 12 in a row. And making a joke out of the American League. They were in Detroit today, and just
he throws to first, and that's the sound of 14 straight victories.
14 straight, the longest run in the bigs this year. It has slingshot the A's into first in the AL West. It's a nice.
This team was written off. How do you explain otherwise? How do you explain otherwise some of the victories that they've come up with?
The Oakland A's are going to win 16 consecutive games. This is the longest win streak in baseball, folks, in 25 years.
Truly, data and analytics is one of those concepts that you want to deploy an organization because you're trying to create some differentiator, you're trying to create a process that's going to streamline some part of the organization, but you have to keep reminding yourself that once you start down the path, you have to have some quick wins, but then you also have to have the ability to know when you need to pivot. And knowing the problem, again, restating that problem many different ways is a strategy that is necessary when you're implementing machine learning, artificial intelligence, data governance, any of these data strategy keywords inside the organization. I mean, you're oftentimes trying to do something that hasn't been done before in the organization. So reiterating the question to yourself, but then also keeping the focus, super important. And at some point, again, you'll have to be able to justify why the project or the initiative is going on. And oftentimes you'll have to find that ROI, right? What's that return on the investment? And it's very subjective to do that. So as part of a good data strategy, you want to define what that ROI is going to be at the very beginning, and then make sure you hit milestones along the way to show that you are getting to that goal, or you're showing micro ROI along the way. Super important. Again, give us a 10 out of 10.
The first guy through the wall, he always gets bloody. Always. This is threatening, not just a way of doing business, but in their minds, it's threatening the game. But really what it's threatening is their livelihood. It's threatening their jobs. It's threatening the way that they do things. And every time that happens, whether it's a government or a way of doing business or whatever it is, the people who are holding the reins, have their hands on the switch, they go batshit crazy.
And I think what Moneyball is showing us, and I think why so many people in the data space in particular use this concept, is because they are really trying to get people to coalesce around this vision of saying, hey, we think we have a problem, or we think we can create great value. Let's bring a team together and let's make that happen. Now, just as this conversation is happening in this scene, obviously, those with deeper pocketbooks could potentially do more, but that is all relative.
I mean, anybody who's not tearing their team down right now and rebuilding it using your model, they're dinosaurs.
Not only in this movie, in this scene, but I think it applies to a lot of technology, particularly in the data and analytics space. And we're seeing a lot more of it in the artificial intelligence space. We're watching that play out. So again, great scene, 10 out of 10. If you like videos like these, click above and watch the next one.
Who's Fabio?
It's a shortstop. This is a shortstop from Seattle.
Yeah, this is no time to push the panic button.